Tonight, Secretary of State Rex Tillerson in Moscow, about to attempt one of his toughest conversations. Here to tell the foreign minister, if not Vladimir Putin himself, who so far has not scheduled a meeting with him, that Russia needs to, quote, rethink its backing of Syrian President Bashar al-Assad, and that the U.S. will hold Russia accountable for the continuing carnage there.
It's clear to all of us that the reign of the Assad family is coming to an end. We are not presupposing how that occurs, but I think it is clear that we see no further role for the Assad regime longer term.
What he's up against, a Russia that has called U.S. strikes on Syria an inadmissible act of aggression, intensifying the tension between the two countries. Russian President Putin today suggesting that the Assad regime and Russia are being framed for the chemical attack, saying more will follow.
We have information from various sources that this kind of provocation, I can't call it anything other than a provocation, is being prepared for in other regions of Syria too, including the southern suburbs of Damascus, where they are preparing to drop similar chemicals and then accuse the Syrian government of it.
Comparing it to the Iraq War in 2003, with claims of weapons of mass destruction since proven false.
The Iraq campaign was launched, and it finished with the destruction of the country, the growth of the terrorist threat, and nothing less than the emergence of ISIS on the international stage.
He says Russia will appeal to the international community for a full investigation of last week's chemical attack. But when Secretary Tillerson, before landing in Moscow, met with G7 nations in Italy, discussed the possibility of sanctioning Russia, for at the very least allowing there to still be chemical weapons in Syria, they were not on board.
We must have a dialogue with Russia. We must not push Russia into a corner.
As far as the rhetoric has now gone between Russia and the U.S.,
Putin's a war criminal. Assad's a war criminal. When Secretary Tillerson says he hopes that Russia will realign itself with Western democracies and break away from Syria and Iran, with all due respect, I like Secretary Tillerson. That's pretty naive.
The responsibility falls now on Tillerson, the first to sit down face-to-face with his Russian counterpart and try to gain some cooperation with the government he once considered a friend.